Mission is nothing but it is the things which they have to take into consideration in order to reach that particular vision. Mental image, because it is the brain work of the organization. Why we call it as a motivator? Because only when you motivate the people, then you can achieve whatever you want. And what the feature says? It says it should be original and unique. Hello students, welcome you all to the session 2 of business policy class. Hi, George LMA, Commerce Faculty, Department of Commerce, Vidyashram First Grade College, Mysuru. Dear students, today in this session 2 of unit 1, we are going to discuss about the vision, mission and the strategies, that is the goals and objectives of the organization, which will be helpful for the betterment of the organization. So it says management of companies is very much essential. So management of companies is very much essential in order for the growth and development of the company. So before going to this session, I'll just give the highlights of this session. One, that is in the last class what I explained to you, I'll just give a brief description about it. I explained to you about the business policy, that is the meaning of business policy. It says, as I told you, it is a guidelines which has been developed by the organization in order to put that into action, right? And I also explained to you about the features. In features, I said it should be specific, it should be clear, then it should be reliable, it should be uniform as well as appropriate and simple, and it should be comprehensive as well as it should be flexible structure or the stable. Then coming to the next topic which I covered to you is about the nature of the business policy, the meaning of strategic management. What is the strategy? I explained to you that it is derived from the Greek word called strategos or stratus, where it says the army or to lead. So strategy means it is an idea, or it may be a tactics which has been implemented for the fulfillment or to in order to achieve the goals or the targets or the objectives of the organization. Then the features of the strategy I explained to you, that task of strategic management, the 5 components and the difference between the policy and strategy. So these are the various important topics which I had covered to you in the last session, that is in session 1. Now coming to today's session, in session 2, we shall see about the vision, mission and the objectives of the organization along with the goals and plans. Now it says if the company has to be developed, if any company has to be developed, then it has to have a proper systematic growth and development can be done only when there is a proper management. So only when there is a proper management, then you can see the company's growth and development can take place. So it says the management strategies are formulated in such a way that the company achieves its growth as well as the development. For that, there should be a proper vision, proper mission, as well as the proper planning, the goals and the objectives, right? So in line with them, all the goals and objectives have been set for the company for the growth and development of the particular company or the organization or an institution. So if any company has to flourish, then, or it should be in the market, then the proper strategies has to be followed. Now, which are the strategies? I told you the management strategies has to be taken into consideration for the growth and development. Before growth and development, there should be the existence of that particular institution or an organization. Existence is very important. First, you need to have the existence, then only you can have the growth, and then the development can take place. Without this, it is not possible to be there in the market for a longer run, right? So this is about the introduction part. Now coming to the introduction, in introduction itself, there are other things which I am going to explain to you, that is the mission and vision strategies. What is this mission and vision strategies? The mission and the vision strategies, they play a important vital role in the growth and development of an organization. So right, it provides the important screening of strategic points. So this will help you to see that where you have to reach and for that what you have to do. So what is a vision? Vision is nothing but it is an image of an organization to see. So it is the image where the organization sees where it has to reach or where it has to be. And what is a mission? Mission is nothing but it is the things which they have to take into consideration in order to reach that particular vision. So vision is a image, or it may be a mindset, or it may be brainstorming work, or it may be what you call it as a dream. Now for example, if you want to have a car or you want to buy a car, then you should dream for a car. First of all, you should dream for a car. Then only for buying that particular car, what are the things or what are strategies you need to look into or take into consideration, right? For that, you need to see that you apply for a loan, or you may be having some cash, or you may borrow some cash from others, right? And see that you purchase that dream car or a dream house. So this is all the various important strategies which is very much important on part of the organization. So understanding the concept of vision and mission and goals and objectives, it has been related and it is very much important for the essentials of implementing a successful strategic management. So the vision, mission and the goals and objectives are very, very important on part of the companies or the organization, because that will help you in implementing the success of that particular management or that particular organization. Now each organization has to have a very clear and clear vision as well as the mission and goals or the objectives. Only when a company or an organization has a proper vision, mission and the goals or the objectives and the plans, then it says it makes the business a movement. Then only you can have a movement for your organization or for your business. If you don't have the vision, then automatically you don't have the mission. That is, you cannot do anything because you don't have that plan, or you don't have that image, or you don't have the dream. When you don't have the dream or an image, then automatically you are not going to do anything for that. When you don't have the mission, then automatically what happens? You don't have the objectives. When there is no objectives, there is no goals. That is, the no targets to be reached. And there is no goals, then automatically there is no need of doing any planning. So all these are interlinked. It is connected to one another. So the vision, mission, objectives, goals, plans, all these are interlinked. So each one has a link. It is like a chain link which has connected to each other. So that's what it says. It says it is a mental image of the organization. So the vision is a mental image of an organization. Why we call it as a mental image? Mental image because it is the brain work of the organization, where the top level management people, they sit and they will think about what should be their future prospects, where they have to land, where they have to reach, right? So like this, there are strategies which has to be taken into consideration on part of vision. A strategic imperative is an initiative or a project. What is a strategic imperative? Imperative, it is a project or the major objectives which is having a systematic or a over a particular next 6 to 12 months. That is, in order to signify or move a team or organization towards its desired goals or the culture. So it is nothing but they have some ideas where they want to go and how they are going to reach it. So that is about this strategic imperative. Now this strategic imperative, it says it is simply put in a clearly defined outcome essentials in order to achieve the growth goals. This particular strategic imperative, it is very simple in nature, and it says it has been defined clearly that the outcomes of this, whatever the outcomes, those essentials has to be achieved in order to grow as well as in order to reach the target or the goals. Now example, I see, you can see here, it is a basis for the product, that is a uniqueness. The basis for product is a uniqueness. What is that uniqueness? The basis for a product, they call it as it should have a uniqueness. That means something different from other products. So that particular product which you produce or manufacture should be different from other products. That is called uniqueness, a defensible patent. Now what are the organization? Here a question arises. What are the organization wants to achieve? What are the organization wants to achieve? That means it has been reflected by the mission, vision and the objectives of the organization. If your organization wants to achieve something, then it has to depend upon the vision, mission and the objectives of the organization. Simply, if you don't have the vision, mission and the objectives or the goals or the plans, then you cannot achieve whatever you want. So the achievement has been reflected on part of the vision, mission as well as the objectives of the companies, right? And second question is how they are going to achieve it. That is how they are going to achieve the above what. Now you have some achievement. You have some achievement that you want to achieve something. So after 10 years, I want to be the number one in the market. Now that is the first one here. It says what you want to achieve. You should be number one in position. Correct? Then for this, what you have to do? That is the next question is asking here. How they are going to achieve them, whatever the above said. Now, how you are going to achieve that? For that, you need to do lot of work. Lot of work has to be undertaken into consideration, right? You need to do so much of work, so much of hard work has to be put in. Then different kinds of innovation you have to do. The marketing strategies you have to take, right? Product strategies, finance strategies, each and HRM strategies or HR strategies, each and everything has to be taken into consideration in order to achieve your number one position in the market, right? So it says these strategies are long-term and short-term prospectives. Whatever the strategies you follow in order to reach this number one position is nothing but the long-term as well as short-term strategies you need to take into consideration. So this is about the total of the what I explained to you is about the introduction part. Now coming to the first is vision. We call it as the strategic intent. Strategic intent. In strategic intent, we have vision, mission, objectives, goals and plans. Out of that, this is the first one. It says the vision. What is a vision? As I told you, vision is an image which an organization sees. It is an image where the organization sees or it looks into. Where they are looking into? They are looking into that I want to be first in the number one position in the market. My product should be number one products. I have to reach 1,000 or I have to reach lakh or million people. My market share should be of increased by 20% in next 10 years. I have to build a house within 2 years. I need to buy a car that is within 1 year. See, that is a vision, right? So a vision is a big picture of what? It is what? A vision is a big picture of what? What? The question mark. What you want to achieve? Where you want to land? That is the question I hear about the vision. It is a big picture. Why it is a big picture? Because it is a very big picture where it says it is a big achievement which you are going to take in future or which you are going to achieve. So what the organization wants to achieve in future, that is what it says. So it is a big picture of what an organization has to achieve in future. I told you so many things what the organization may want to achieve in future, right? So, and that will inspire the people in the organization. If you want to achieve something, then you should have a proper vision and the proper clear vision should be there. And that it should be informed to the persons or the employees or subordinates who are working in your organization. So, you should inspire them, motivate them. In order to do the work, then only you can see what you have to reach and where you have to reach. So it excites the people to be part of what? So the people who are working with you, when you inspire them, when you motivate them, then automatically it says you are going to be, that is, they are going to be excited. So the people will be excited to do work with you. Even they'll be more enthusiastic to work with you in order to attain that particular achievement, and also motivates the motivate to put their energy and time and to achieve the future. So they will not just be with you or work with you, they will put their lot of energies, they will put their lot of hard work and see that you are going to achieve what is that, the future, what you want to become or what you want to achieve. So a vision is what keeps the organization moving forward. Vision, when only when vision is there, the organization can move forward. When there is no vision, you cannot move further. Now, for example, I'll take an example of yourself. You as a student, you should have a vision. What is that vision? I should, now you are in the degree, right? In the UG, you should do masters. And after masters, I need to do the PhD. Right? After PhD, I should land in some good companies as the managers or the general managers or the directors or board of directors. See, that is the vision. Only when you have the vision, then you can move forward. You can move forward. If you don't have the vision, then you will not continue your studies. You will just finish your degree and just be there. Right? It is a motivator. Vision is what? It is a motivator in the organization. Why we call it as a motivator? Because only when you motivate the people, then you can achieve whatever you want. So it is motivating factor. So it motivates you to see that you have to reach that particular objective or the target. And it should be meaningful along with the long-term perspectives. Right? So that it can motivate people who are working with you or under you. So only when they are motivated, when you are motivated and when they are motivated, combined together, you can achieve whatever you want and you can have the success of your image or you can whatever you are thinking about or the dream. A vision articulates the position the organization would like to attain in the distant future. So it will tell you what the organization wants to achieve in the near future or in the distant future, so that it will be helping in creating a common identity among and the shared purpose. Next one, it says a good vision. When you have a good vision, it will foster risk taking and experimentation. When you have the risk, when you have experimentation, you are doing. Why you are taking all these things? Taking risk and taking the experiments or doing the experiments. When you do the experiments or the research work, the innovations you are doing, right? And also you are taking the risk. For what? In order to see that you want to achieve that particular achievement. You want to reach there. That is why you are taking so much of risk as well as so much of experiments you are doing, right? Otherwise, it will be not be possible to reach to that particular place where you want to whatever you want to achieve. Now, question arises, what will success look like? What will be the success look like? It says, the vision of an organization must possess the following characteristics. If you want to see what is your success, then there should be some important characteristic features of that particular vision. First one, it says, consensus. That is, it should be created by consensus. That means everyone should agree for what you are thinking about, for what you are dreaming about. Secondly, it says, it is a company future's mental image. It is a company's mental image, or it is a mental image means where you want, you are thinking that you want to achieve something. Then it forms a formulation of mission statements. So just having a vision, it is not good, but you should also have some statements, the mission statements, how you are going to achieve that. So a good vision, you can see a good vision possesses the following features. Which are the features? And what the feature says? It says it should be original and unique. The vision should be original. It should be realistic as well as it should be unique. That means it should be something different from others or other things. What you are doing, right? Or what you want to achieve. Then it should foster long run thinking. So you should always think about for a longer run than for a shorter period. Always think about longer period than the shorter period. Then it should be more competitive so that you can compete with your competitors in the market. Then it should be realistic, as I told you, and it should be inspiring also you as well as others in order to achieve that particular target. The examples here you can see, it says company vision. What is the company's vision? It says of Walt Disney. Walt Disney company, their vision is make people happy. Make people happy. So that is their statement, vision statements, right? And Stroke Eye Clinic. So what is their vision? Their vision is, our vision is to take care of your vision. So their vision is, they say that we want to take care of your vision, that is your eyesights. So, and what is about Infosys? Infosys also having some vision. And what that vision statement says, it says globally respected organization. Everyone knows that Infosys is a globally accepted organization, and it is also a respected organization, and that will provide the best of whatever the breed, the solution they are giving, right? And also using the latest technologies which has been delivered to the people. So these are the examples for the vision. So students, have you understood this vision part? Let us go to the mission. I told you there should be vision. When there is vision, there should be a mission. Now what is this mission? Mission is nothing but it is a founder's intention. It is a founder's intention means what he wants to say, the purpose. It says why that particular organization is existing, the purpose of that organization. What is the reason why that organization is there, right? So what they wanted to achieve, that is very important. This mission states what they want to achieve. First is, you want to achieve something. Now for that, what you have to do for that? And in dynamic environment, it says in this present environment, so it is re-examined as well as refreshed periodically. So the statement of mission says, when you want to do something, that means you need to take into consideration the external factors, the internal factors, each and everything. So periodically, it should be ever changing according to the situations, according to the situation arises. A mission refers to the purpose. As I told you, it is the purpose of an organization. Why that particular organization is existing? What is the necessity of that particular organization? So the mission states the business reason for the organization's existence. So this mission will tell you why it is existing, why the organization is existing. I told you, first thing, the purpose. Now it will say the reason why it is existing, that will relate to the organization of the society. So it relates to the organization of society means it is living there or it is existing. The purpose of the a company or organization or the mission is to see that, to render services or to give the commodities to the society at large. So this is about the mission. Now there are other things about the mission where we say that it should have the high and same time. So this mission should have the high as well as same time, and it should be realistic. It is realistic because it should provide a proper direction to the organization. Only when that mission gives a proper direction to the organization, then only you can do whatever you want in order to achieve that particular vision which you are having, right? And it is a fundamental work given by the society to the organization. What is that fundamental society? The basic or the primary work which has been given by the society for the organization to do that particular work. That is satisfying the wants of the people, satisfying the human wants, food, clothing and shelter, right? To provide food, to provide clothing, to provide the shelter. So that is what the society has given. So that is what the mission of that organization should be. The company mission is defined as, it is a unique purpose, and that will set whatever the business apart from other firms or the types. Now students, coming to the effective characteristics of this particular mission. It says a mission statement should be realistic and it should be achievable. Whatever the mission statements you are giving, it should be a realistic as well as it should be achievable. And if it is not, then that particular, it says impossible statements do not innovate or motivate people. If you don't give a motivation, if there is no inspiration or motivation, whatever the statement you give in the mission, that will be a flop. So then secondly it says it should not be too broad, it should not be too lengthy, as well as it should not be narrow. It should not be narrow. It should not be broad, nor it should be lengthy, as well as it should not be narrow in sense. Whatever the statement you give, it should be very precise. It says it should be precise. That is, in a short. Then the mission statement should not be ambiguous, and it should be clear for action. There should not be any kind of confusions or misunderstandings, and it should be totally clear from the confusions as well as the misunderstandings, right? A mission statement should be distinct, means it should be different. If it is not distinct, then it will not have any impact over that particular statement. This copied mission statements do not create any kind of impressions. You should have something different from others. That's what it says. So the mission statement should be different and distinct from others. If you copy the same, whatever the others statements, mission statements, what they are given, if you copy it according to them, and that will not have any weightage, and that will not create any impression on the minds of the people. Then it should have this social linkage. What is the social linkage? It says linking the organized society to build a long-term prospective in the society. How we are going to do that? How we are going to have a social link or societal link? That is by way of by rendering the social service to the society. Now I'll give an example. Now this is pandemic time. During this pandemic time, most of the people have lost their jobs. They don't have the jobs, or they don't, salary is not been given to most of the people, right, who are working there. So most of them have lost the jobs, as well as they are already in despair. So in that condition, there is nothing to eat. So when there is no job, automatically there is no money. When there is no money, then they cannot feed themselves. So at this time, it is the duty of the organization, or it is the obligation of the organization, to see that provide some food materials, some food kits. So that will be more helpful to the people or the society. Surely they will be looking for it. Surely the people will be looking for it from the society side. So it will be a great good deed from your organization side. So that is what it says, the social links. Likewise, construction of the parks, or construction of some roads, right? Then some lakes to be regenerated. All this can be taken into consideration as part of this mission. Then it should not be static. This particular mission statement, it should not be a static one. It should be free, flexible. Freeness should be there. You can change according to the requirements, right? Then it should be motivating to the members. Only when you motivate, inspire the members working with you, then they will be the persons who will be working hard, putting lot of energy, as I told you, putting lot of energy and working hard towards achievement of that particular target or whatever your vision is. Then it says the mission statement should indicate the process of accomplishing the objectives. Whatever the mission statement you give, it should be, see that that statement should be of in order to achieve the vision. That should be the main intention, or that should be the main point. So here you can see some of the companies, they are given the mission statements. First we'll take up Amazon. So everyone knows Amazon. What is Amazon? Where you get all kinds of products you can purchase online. During this pandemic time, it is more helpful to the people, right? So what is their mission statement? The mission statement, it says to be Earth's most customer-centric company. They want their company to be most customer-oriented, and where they can find the customer and discover anything they might want to buy online. So here they are giving the statement saying that they want their company to be mostly of customer, it is very important, customer-centric company. And they see that they want the customers to come and purchase the things, whatever they want, through online, right? Now coming to the Google, what is Google statement for mission? The Google's mission statement says to organize the world's information and make universe accessible and useful. Everyone knows that Google, if you put something, whatever you want to search, you get it. So The statement of Google company, it says to organize the world information, whatever the information you require, that is about the world, that you get it and make it universe accessible. So they want everyone to use it and make use it in a better manner or in the to the best of whatever they are searching for. Then L'Oreal, to provide the best cosmetic innovations. So L'Oreal company or L'Oreal company, it is a company which is giving the cosmetics, or they are producing, manufacturing the cosmetics, right? So for the men and women. So those who are searching, who want to become like more attractive, or you want to become more beauty. So you can use the products of L'Oreal. That's what it says. Their mission is, statement says, to provide the best, what is that? Cosmetic innovations, innovation, that is for the women and men around the world in respect of their diversity, whatever may be the criteria, both for women and men, both for women and men, this company, L'Oreal company, their statement is to provide a very good cosmetics products. Then last one is Myco Clinic. It is inspiring, the statement says, to inspire hope and contribution of health and well-being. So this particular mission statement of Myco Clinic is saying that to inspire the people to have a good health as well as well-being by providing the best care for every patient, that is through integration, clinical practice, education and research. So this is about the mission statement of various companies. Now students, coming to the components, these are very, very important on part of the companies, because it says these are the diverse issues which will have a greater impact over the company's mission statements. So which are the various components, that is of various companies is giving a mission statement? That particular mission statement component says, first one, it should be of product or service. Secondly, it should have customers. Then survival, growth and profitability. Then it should have technology. Then companies, philosophy and public image. So, and customers. These are the various important the components of a proper and a well mission statements. So the mission statement should include all these important aspects which I told you now, that is product, service, then our service, the customers, technology, then we have public image, company's growth, then survival, growth and profitability. All this has to be taken into consideration when you form a mission statement or when you create a mission statement. So students, so these are the important topics for today's session. I've explained to you each and everything, right? So before going back, let us again glance once again what are the important topics which I have explained to you. So that is just the headlines, I'll give you the highlights of it. First, I explained to you about the introduction part, that is about vision, mission and the statements of vision, mission, then how it is helpful to for the organization. Then explain to you about the questions which arises at the time of vision and mission. Then what is a vision? How it is going to motivate or inspire the organization and the people who are working along with the organization in order to achieve the vision? Then whatever the question arises there, how they are going to be successful, that is successful, how their success will be achieved through vision. Then what are the important aspects taken into consideration for the vision? That is the features we say. So it should be inspiring, then long-term thinking, original and unique, then it should be competitive, I told you, and realistic. Then the examples of various companies given by different companies according to their statements of vision. Then what is the mission? That is what you're going to do, or what is the purpose of that particular organization? I explained to you about that. Then the characteristic features of the mission we can see here. So I told you it should be achievable or realistic. Then it should be precise and it should be clear. It should not be having any misunderstanding or any kind of doubts. Then it should be realistic. Then it should be distinct from others. It should not be copied. The mission statement should not be copied from other companies. It should have their own mission statements. Otherwise, it will not have any kind of impression on the minds of the people or the customers. Then it should be linking with the society, thereby helping the society at a larger scale by doing or undertaking the social works, right? And it should not be static. It should be free enough so that you can change according to the situation and according to the environment and the competition. Then these are the mission examples of various companies given by Amazon, Google, Lorera and Mayo Clinic. And these are the components where when you prepare the mission statement, these are the important components where it should be taken into consideration while preparing a mission statement. So students, I hope that you understood the topics we have covered to you. I'll be leaving the class now. See you in the next class. Take care. Stay safe. Have a nice day.